We should be in spring football right now. We are not, but that doesn't mean that we're not going to be catching up with coaches from around the state. One of those coaches we're excited to talk to is the head coach of the Mansfield Summit Jaguars. We're joined by Coach Channon Hall. Coach, how you doing?
Doing well. Trying to stay busy and stay creative.
Yeah. First and foremost, like the most important question these days is how are you? How are your family? How are you guys holding up?
Yeah, everybody's good in the house. You know, just like I said, trying to stay busy, trying to stay creative. I have four kids, so, you know, they keep each other busy and different things like that. But, you know, it's different, but we're adjusting and trying to thrive and make it happen any way possible.
They keep each other busy. They also keep dad busy, though, right?
No question about it.
I want to ask a little bit about your 2019 Jaguars. A 7-4 year, you guys are able to make it into the playoffs. You know, after you know, a bounce back year after the year before. I'm interested kind of in how you would sum up what you guys were able to accomplish in 2019.
We did some good things. Being in a tough district in 6A, as everyone knows, I thought we were very competitive. I thought we did some great things. Thought we won some big games. Had a lot of growth that year. But also, I thought we kind of had a lull. We hit a lull, and we made the playoffs, but we didn't finish strong. And it was something to build on, something to learn from. And we just proved we can beat anybody, and then we proved we can lose to anybody. So when you have those two things, you know, it's like – salt and pepper. So we had to pick and choose which one to throw out and get better and make sure that narrative changes next year.
And so, you know, because you look back on last year, I think you're exactly right. A big win over DeSoto, right? You know, that's mm-hmm. that's a kind of signature win for a season, but then kind of a 3-game losing streak to finish the year. You know, has that been kind of an emphasis for you guys during the off season as far as, you know, making sure that each week you're treating it like you're playing a state-ranked team like DeSoto?
No question. It's just no days off, and you got to prepare like it's the last game of the season every time. You know, we're going to live and we learn from that experience, that 3-game losing streak, and we're going to make sure that doesn't happen again. I can guarantee you that, and that's been the emphasis this entire spring. And even while we're out right now, that's what we're talking to the kids about, and that's what we have to hold our hat on.
Speaking of which, you know, obviously these are strange times. You know, we're all sitting at home, you know, socially distancing, and I'm interested in how you're staying connected with your guys. I know that, you know, you 2020 football season's still coming. There's not going to be any excuses whenever the ball is snapped. How are you staying connected with your guys?
You know, there's a lot of different apps out there, you know, Teams, Sports U. So we're just staying connected, you know, trying to, again, like I said, be creative, send out workouts. You know, this week, you know, we're spring install right now. We have position meetings, offensive meetings, so defensive meetings. So right now is really one, the primary focus first was to get all the coaches on the same page, make sure we're speaking the same language, seeing the same things. And my coaches have done an outstanding job of just being in tune in the moment and making sure that there's growth. You know, with so much stuff out there, the colleges are doing fabulous by letting us be in their meetings. All these websites have these different seminars. So, I mean, the coaching development and growth should be at its premium right now. And my job is to make sure my coaches are taking advantage of all that. So we're getting on the same page, followed by the kids getting with us. We're going to bring them along slowly because it's going to be a long process. So we're not just going to give it all to them, but just little by little, just to make sure we're all speaking the same language and we understand how we finished the season last year and to make sure it doesn't happen again that way.
We're talking with Channon Hall, the head coach of the Mansfield Summit Jaguars here on Texas Football Today. Get involved with the conversation at hashtag TF Today. Coach, I think one of the big questions going forward has to do with realignment. You guys, on one hand, dropping from 6A to 5A. I'm sure that's not necessarily something you're complaining about, but at the same time, you're also thrust into, boy, maybe one of the deepest, toughest districts in all of 5A. All 8 teams made the playoffs last year. I mean, so how do you balance that? You know, from your perspective, whenever realignment came out, you guys are going to be dropping down. You know, dropping down a classification, good district, something else. So how do you kind of assess how you guys landed in realignment?
Yeah, I mean, it just kind of went with our theme, is what me and you've been talking about, you know, can beat anybody, can lose to anybody. And this just proves with this district, just, hey, everybody's good. Everybody you're going to play next year, good. 5A, 6A, don't matter. Everybody's good. Everybody's been in the playoffs. Everybody's seasoned. Everybody's going to want to get back in, and everybody's not going to be able to get back in. So what side are we going to be on? You know, and that's just the overarching theme, that let's be on the good side of this thing. Let's finish strong. Let's work like, you know, like it's a district championship every time. And our goals are in place, and there's no way it's going to be easy. And we know that, and we wouldn't have it any other way.
But you are, this is a team, looking forward to your 2020 squad. This is a team that brings back a lot of experience. You know, you guys are bringing back 15 starters, some guys kind of at key roles in different parts of the squad. I'm interested, do you have a feeling quite yet on what you think this team is going to be about? What maybe is this team going to hang its hat on in the 2020 season?
Well, that never is going to change. You can look at any of my interviews from the last 10 years of being head coach, and it's always going to be on defense. We're going to play some good defense. I mean, I just believe in that and create the team with my staff like that, and our dogs on D. And it starts with our D-line. We have a lot of guys coming back on the D-line, and we feel good about those guys. So that's going to be the key, the anchor in the middle. And then we got everybody in the secondary coming back as well, with Sean Smith, Jalen Rock, and Simmons. So, you know, Ahmad Moses. So, I mean, on those levels, on that first level and the back level, we have experienced guys that made a lot of plays for us. And coming back, we want to lead the troops defensively next year. Then, you know, look, on the offensive side, we got Jacoby Jackson anchoring our O-line. You know, 6'5", 320, we feel good about him. And Hal Presley out wide, you know, at receiver, you know, at 6'3", 200 pounds. And then we have, you know, Kanan McKinney, David Hopkins, and we have all these guys coming back that have great experience. And those guys, they just got to lead the troops, and they got to make plays. And it starts with those guys. But, I mean, we got some guys also that have just been itching to get out there and get their shot, and I feel like they're going to be ready to go.
And finally, Coach, you mentioned you're at home, wife, four kids. This is a time when coaches are spending a lot more time at home than they normally do basically any other time of the year. So my question is, how are the kids holding up with dad around all the time?
Oh, man, it's awesome, man. It's awesome. This is a, you know, you got to just take these blessings as they come, you know. And I have a son going off to college in the fall, so. You know, this time's just been fun. You know, we, you know, my daughter, she has me doing dances and plays and massages and all kind of stuff. So we stay busy, man, try to keep it fun, try to keep it light. And, you know, dad just tries to stay out the way sometime. You know, I'm the play buddy most of the time. And, you know, they want to play pranks on dad and all that good stuff. My wife's a teacher as well, and she stays busy. She's creative. So, you know, it never stops around here, man. It never stops. I just cook. That's what I want to do. Just cook and stay busy.
That's the right move. If you need daddies in the kitchen.
Yeah. Stay on the grill, you know, stay and do my thing, you know.
He's Channon Hall. He's the head coach of the Mansfield Summit Jaguars. Coach, really appreciate your time. Please stay safe, and we'll be talking to you down the road.
You do the same. Go Jags.